While appearing before the Parliamentary Public Accounts Committee in charge of local government, the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Public Service, Christine Bitarakwate, disdains the ministry from illegal salary deductions of employees in local governments, saying approval of loans is done at local government levels.
It's not correct that Ministry of Public Service makes deductions for employees on the MDS / local government payrolls. Deductions are part of the employee's salary whose processing and payment is decentralized. It is not separate from the other payments. Approval for all loans is by the responsible officer of that entity, or his or her designate.
According to the Auditor General's report of the financial year that ended June 2022, the Ministry of Public Service deducted 20.8 billion Uganda shillings from 15,000 staff in 44 local governments without letters of undertaking or consent from affected staff. 1.45 billion shillings was deducted by the ministry from 2,143 employees past the end of the date of deduction, while 4.74 billion was unrealistically deducted from 2,729 employees in 69 local governments.
There is a lot of negligence on the part of many local government entities. There is also that capacity-related challenges with many local government entities. But also three on your side is that your team are not helping you do a good job.
Committee members pointed at the irregular arrangement which was established by the Ministry of Public Service to manage deductions.
We should get rid of the blame game. There is a lot going on. Every time the committee meets different entities, every entity ends up defending itself. Yet it is the public, it is that public servant who suffers care of the negligency from any entity. So we have to go and get to the ground cause of everything, because there is a challenge either with the system or with the capacity, the manpower implementing the system.
Legislators have called for a review of the loan deduction system used on civil servants, saying it has affected the livelihoods of civil servants as they continue to lose their salary in illegal and unrealistic deductions.
Who is responsible for deductions? I know there are guidelines which have been published, but even with those guidelines, we are seeing employees crying that they have, many lenders, their salaries have been deducted too much. Even some people have left work.
Public service has become a ministry specializing in producing systems. Year in, year out, they are coming out with a new system. One is called IPBS. Next year, they have brought IIS. The other year, they have brought IPPS. Some of them, they don't talk to one another. They are busy creating only non-payments. Even this problem of deduction are systems that are isolated.
The committee questioned the Ministry of Public Service for delayed access to pension payroll by new pensioners in various local governments. Committee members tasked the ministry to clean up the pension payroll to save the government from accruing huge arrears in pension.
In the 2021-22 audit report, you will realize that over 1,000 pensioners delay to access their pension benefits for between 50 to 110 months.
The whole process from the recruitment up to that point. Issues, when we went to the ground, issues of is it missing documents, whatever. What is that is required in the whole process that you are not monitoring?
The Ministry of Public Service blames the query on chief administrative officers of different local governments, saying pension and gratuity processing has been decentralized.
The matter will be conclusively addressed by HCM rollout, because only records verified against national ID are migrated and or created on the HCM. In the meantime, unverified records for local governments still on IPPS can be ended by Ministry of Public Service.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.